In the past, if I walk for 6 minutes, I would feel breathless. Now I can walk, say, a mile, 2 miles. And I was told that I was not fit for the general surgery, open heart surgery to replace the mitral, and that I may be a candidate for a new procedure.
I met George when he came to the hospital. He went through a number of investigations, including an exercise echocardiogram. We knew he was limited by symptoms, but we wanted to assess the mechanism of the symptoms to see exactly what was causing his breathlessness on exertion. We were scanning his heart with a three-dimensional echocardiogram, and we described the lesion of the valve in great detail and the magnitude of the problem. 20 years ago, the surgeon needed to go into the heart first before they actually realized what the lesion, the pathology looked like. Nowadays, the surgeon or the interventional cardiologist can plan the procedure in advance. The patient is taken in the cath lab with a valve condition and is having a transesophageal echocardiogram at the same time. This echocardiogram can be a 3D one or 4D, which means that we have live images of the heart over the time, and the catheters which are forwarded to the heart by the interventional colleague are being viewed live on the screen. So my interventional colleague knows exactly where the catheters are, how the valve is being approached by the catheters. Then the device, which is designed to fix a problem of the valve, to repair the valve, is deployed on the valve.
In the past, when the interventional cardiologist worked on his own in a lab with x-rays, it's now changing that we're really part of a team. And so the interventional cardiologist may be the person moving the catheters, but we're really the imaging cardiologist, the one who provides the three-dimensional images and is really the navigator, and you have to integrate and work very closely with them. So in many respects, they're as much the responsible for the intervention as you are. You may move the catheter, but they tell you where to move it.
This is not an operation. The chest remains closed. Everything is performed via catheterization through the femoral vein and artery, which means that the patient can essentially go home on the following day.
This procedure has enabled me to carry on my daily life, and palpitations are gone, and I'm able now to walk without having any breathlessness.